Hello, welcome to Skye Sweaty Record Review, episode 134. Only first listen new music review show hosted by a French professor immediately after leaving the YMCA. While his fiance moves in stuff in the background. You'll hear some sounds. Doesn't matter. It's going to be a quick episode. I'm just going to be reviewing a single. The artist is Sufjan Stevens. Sufjan? Sufjan Stevens, and the song is called Love Yourself. But it's actually going to be something of an essay about what happened to indie music. And what happened to music in general between the 90s and the teens. And I think you can find that just by listening to this song and then the demo that he also included when he released the song. So he recorded a demo in 96, recorded the actual version in 2019, and what happened in between created all of these differences. Now, first of all, I don't know Sufjan Stevens very well. Would you like to know why? I'll tell you, but I'm gonna save that for the end. I'm gonna make kind of a weirdly personal, perhaps misplaced admission about myself and why I never listened to Sufjan Stevens. But it's kind of a nice thing because I don't have any context. I don't know if this new single, Love Yourself, is wildly out of place in his oeuvre. I don't know if it's totally in keeping. All that I know, the only information that I have about Sufjan Stevens right now is that he released a song called Love Yourself in 2019 and released his 1996 demo at the same time. So I'm going to start with the 1996 demo. It is so 90s. It is so demo. It is painful. I'm just going to play you a little bit of it on my, for some reason, quieter computer these days. And I'll just have you listen to it and talk about it a little bit while we listen to it. So, you know, it starts off, it's over there. There you go. It starts off with just like this mournful guitar. Dun, 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 dun. I think that's a fifth. Dun, 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 dun. And then a second guitar comes in. So, what you can hear here is this aching intimacy, okay? It's got to be the Elliott Smith influence, the double track of his own vocals, the double track of his guitar, and listen to it on Tidal or Spotify or whatever. It's really something. It's a minute and 14 seconds. And it's just this outline of a song. It's just the skeleton of a song, really. And it's this theme of loving yourself and the guitar going gung, 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 gung. And then, 23 years later, he releases Love Yourself, the song, the official song, the not demo, and it's barely recognizable. Here it is. You hear now it's all keyboards. It's a descending arpeggiated keyboard line. The same words. Roughly the same melody, but the vocals have gone from kind of a rough, you know, four-track vocals to super smooth and glossy. He even throws in a couple, you know, the millennial woos there. There's like this drum line that's this electronic drum kit, you know, drum machine, you know, and it's all keyboards. There's no guitar in it at all. And as it goes on, it gets more and more developed. It's a very short song, 3 minutes and 50 seconds. And eventually, there's like wind chimes, you know, number one law. I don't like wind chimes, but it's okay. It's all right in this song. And he sings the same song, but it's just all 2000 teensied. And the question is, like, Sufjan Stevens is a god of indie music, right? I know enough about him to know that. How in the world is this indie music? If you played me this in 1996, I would be like, who is this Phil Collins ass clown? That's what I would say. I would say, this isn't indie music. Okay, now the dogs are fighting. There's lots of ambient noise here. Right? If you told me that this was indie music in 1996, I would not believe you. So what happened? I mean, okay, you could say, okay, computer happened, and the synthesis of electronic music mixed in with indie music. And I think that's true. I think the democratization of technology means that this kind of slick sound can now be associated with independent music as much as it can by professionally funded music, you know? I think all these things can kind of go together. But I think it's more that technological innovation, okay, the usage of electronic and computer music, it's no longer a barrier to intimacy. And I think it used to be. I mean, even when I listen to, like, New Order, okay, I always feel like they're being ironic. Even if they're singing about something that means something to me, it always felt like they were being ironic. I felt there was this distance from the computer. So it's not just that the music is changing and that the genre is changing. It's that our relationship to electronic sounds has fundamentally changed to the point where my daughter listens to Billie Eilish, and it's the way that my generation listened to Elliott Smith. There's no difference. So this is a fascinating comparison. I would just listen to both of them. It'll take you 5 minutes to listen to both of these versions, you know? What else do you hear? Comment in the sections. I hate saying that, but this is the thing. I actually care. My watchers, my sweatpants, are actually quite interesting music listeners. So I am curious. Like, what do you hear in this difference? Because it's more than just one is polished and has more production. It's this question of intimacy. And a funny thing, too, is that when you listen to the demo, you realize there's not that much there to the song. And then you listen to the actual finished song, and there's not that much there. Kind of goofy lyrics, you know, like, take everything you believe in and put it on the shelf or something like that. Very simple ideas. But it ends up being, you know, I listened to the song on repeat while I was exercising. It ends up being a song I ended up really liking. So I promised you I would give you a perhaps misplaced personal admission at the end of this video as to why I've never listened to Sufjan Stevens. I was introduced to Sufjan Stevens in the middle 2000s. And I had just had kids. And the thing about having kids is that fathers also gain weight. They gain weight because, like, they're trying to help the moms eat enough to feed the kids, and there's lots of food everywhere, and it's self-care, and you don't have time to exercise. And so I'd, like, just gained a whole mess of weight, and I felt really bad about myself. And then Sufjan Stevens comes out, and my then-wife shows me, like, how awesome he is, and I just felt jealous. I'm like, who is this young, handsome guy making music? I'm like sitting here like watching John and Kate plus 8 and eating hot dogs. And I just felt bad about myself. So, you know, that's why I don't like Sufjan Stevens. Because fundamentally, I have problems loving myself. Wait a minute. Sufjan Stevens is telling me to love myself. So it all kind of goes full circle. And, you know, even, you know, last night, like, I ate some Chipotle and I got super, super bloated. They're not a sponsor. It's pooping my brains out. I felt terrible. They're really not a sponsor. And I, like, felt like kind of like fat. And it reminded me of those times. And I, like, this weird sort of dysmorphia I have about myself. And that's probably part of the reason why I go to the gym so much and why I review these videos. And it's this whole circle. But I'm going to take Sufjan Stevens' advice and love myself. Or not. Or just hate myself just enough to be productive. Worked so far. Okay, so what do you think? How has pop music progressed? Has it devolved? Evolved? Is there a sacrifice in intimacy by the fact that this song has no guitar, is just a guy singing with keyboards? Let me know, or don't. I don't care. Hey, there's the camera.